Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. When we talk about doctors or medicine, we normally get lost in specializations. So, you have to go from door to door, you go to the ENT fellow and tell him, sir, I got a tremendous pain in my left ear. He will coolly say, I am very sorry, please go somewhere, I am a right ear specialist. Speciality is when you know more and more about less and less. And the most specialist person is the one who knows everything about nothing. But when we talk about scriptures, scriptures have to take care of everyone. See, when we see some North Indian marriages in Delhi, there the number of dishes available for your lunch or food is so much. Not one or two or three, but there will be 10 types of vegetables, 20 types of sweets, 30 types of rice, so many of them. And we are Indians. So we go there, not with a plate, but with a parat. And take everything. Now, so much options are given for us to know what is suitable for us. You don't have to take everything. No, bada pyar se banaya hai, let him do it. You must know what suits you. Otherwise, you know, the life becomes impossible because we don't understand what we are doing. Similarly, our scriptures also address all types of people. Those who are body-oriented, those who are action-oriented, those who are emotions-oriented, those who are logic, intellect-oriented, different types of people. See, in our religion it is so simple. One God, one day, one way and over. You people have got so many things. Yes, we have decided the same way. Make a uniform standard and fit the soldiers in that. If somebody is longer than that, cut him. If somebody is shorter, then pull him to make fit to that dress. See, friends, you cannot tell everything to everybody. There are different types of people. And when we don't understand this, we get confused. Therefore, this Upanishad tells, first of all, find out for what you are fit. Because somebody is doing meditation, I want to do meditation. So somebody is doing pranayam, I want to do pranayam. Somebody goes to climb this Himalaya, I want to go there. This is not a spiritual life. You find out what is your natural inclination. So we will find there are two types of minds or human beings. Those who are interested to live in this world and those who are interested to transcend the world. Like those who are interested to fulfill their desires and those who are interested to transcend the desires, two of them. The first type of people fall in the category of samsara and here they are given the instruction. What are the instructions given? Instructions given, tena tyaktena bhunjita ma grudakasya siddhanam kurvanne veha karamani jiji visheshatakam sama. So, live in this world, fulfill your desires, nothing wrong. But remember one thing. that fulfillment of the desire will not lead to fulfillment of life. Continue doing nothing wrong. Similarly, Mahakrita Kasya Siddhanam. How many things and how much money we want to accumulate for what? One day, somewhere there was a mock parliament kind of thing, and they asked me, Swamiji, suppose you are made Prime Minister of India and you are given a freedom. You can make any law which will be acceptable. So I said, okay. So what law you will make? I said, definitely not in-law. Then what law? I said, a simple law. The right of inheritance of property, movable, immovable, should be scrapped. See? Have huge houses, live luxuriously, nothing wrong. But when you depart, it goes to government. All your accumulation. Immediately it will stop. Then what will happen? We will live fully, happily. We know that anyway, he is not going to come with me, nor is he going to go to children. So spend luxuriously and enjoy life. But this should not be done the wrong way. Don't earn wealth the wrong way and don't indulge in the wrong way. Then the teacher gives us technique. Kurvanneveha karmani jiji visheshatagam sama. Earn properly, enjoy properly. Evam tvai, in this way, na anyatha astita. Other than this, there is no better scheme of living a dignified life of a cultured human being. This is for those who take this world as real, and those who want to achieve something, protect something, for them this is the scheme given. But everybody is not like that. See, everybody cannot be said, no, you must get married. There was one boy, he came to me and said, Swamiji, please help me. I said, money I don't give. Ask anything else. He said, no. See, I want to take to sannyas, but my mother tells me, get me married. What should I do? I said, get married. He said, you so casually telling get married. I said, look here. Those who want to take sannyas, they don't go and ask, collect, voting. Should I take? Should I not? Should I take? I said, you are not capable. No, but my mother is insisting again and again. I said, you tell her, get married once more, not me. See, friends. So when you are enough of this world, see, friends, wise people learn from the experiences of others. Drinking and drugs destroy a person. To learn this, you don't have to drink and have drugs. There are many guinea pigs who are doing experiments for you. See, friends, in the same manner, there is one lady, now her daughter is married. When she was not married, the daughter used to come and tell me, Swamiji, tell my mother, she is very irresponsible. So I kept quiet. She is not concerned about my marriage. And she tells me, beta, don't get married. I got married and I know there is nothing in there, useless. So why don't you enjoy your life? Don't get married. Now tell me, is a mother like this who is not taking care of the marriage of the daughter? I said, your mother is wise, but you are otherwise. You suffer. See, friends. Therefore, those who are no more interested in all these things, for them the path is given. What is the path? First of all, those who do not change their vision, Ishavasyamidam sarvam yatkinja jagatyam jagat. And with this understanding, those who do not live, the Upanishad gives us a threatening. Asurya namate loka andhena tamasa vrata tagamste pratyabhigacchanti eke jatmano jana. They will go to hell. It is only by fear people can behave properly. It's very clear. Indians, when they are in India, they are horrible. But the same people, when they go to Singapore, how disciplined they are. It is not love for Singapore. But when you jump the red light, you immediately get a ticket. And the ticket is not only in dollars, so many dollars, plus 10 whips on your back. So you go there. And they are so concerned about our clothes. Remove your clothes. You know, you don't want to spoil your clothes. And give 3 hard. And then we fall down. Again, they are very concerned. They will take you to the hospital and do all treatment at government expense. And write on that, 3 done, 7 balance. Next time, you will never break the rule. See, friends. Therefore, Asurya namate loka andhena tamasa vrata tagamte pratyami gacchanti eke jatmano jana. If the principle of rebirth is not accepted, nothing can justify why we should be good. See, Charvaka says, Rudam krutva grutam pibet. Take money, and go to UK and live happily. See? This is called a liquid spirituality. But when you are walking solid spirituality, then we come to know that if we do something wrong, it doesn't go unnoticed. In the next life, you will have to suffer. And this is how the principle of rebirth is introduced. And then we see also in the world, see, this person is suffering so much. Why all the diseases are coming to him? His other brothers, sisters are all right. You know, in the last life, he has done bad karma. This is the karma phala, and therefore is suffering. Oh God. So, if you do bad karma, you will also have the same thing. No, no, Baba, I don't want to do that. And then we start behaving properly. It is not out of love. It is out of fear. See, friends. And in this manner, Asurya namate loka andhena tamasa vrata, this fear is introduced, then we start behaving properly. Now to such a person, the teacher tells, then who are you? What is the truth? Then up to the 8th mantra, Upanishad tells, Aneja dekam manasojaviyo nanyad deva apnuvat purvam arshat tad dhavato anyana teti tishtat tasminnapo matarishvada dati. Now a person who is withdrawn from the world of his own choice and is at peace with himself, to such a person only contemplation is possible. See, and this is why we gave you the mantra. Wherever we are, whatever we are, we have to live 100%. Such a mind alone can be contemplative. And that mind is all the time agitated, disturbed, oh, I have to do this, I have to do that. How can they understand each other's definition? So, anejadekam manasojaviyo anejad, that which is without any changes, it is ever the same. Ekam, it is one without a second. Manasojaviyo supports all the modifications of the mind without undergoing any modification. Nanad deva apnuvan purva marshat, all the sense organs, etc., they are at the periphery, they cannot touch this absolute self. And in this manner, when we become more and more subjective, then we come to discover, really, in our whole life, what we have done. See, friends. Then dispassion happens. Withdrawal from the world happens under two conditions. One is the dispassion, and second is depression. What is dispassion? What is depression? Somebody went for one interview. And an Indian went for an interview. And they were testing his integrity. So they asked, what is your email ID? He said something. Okay. What is the password? He said, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then he said, you can't protect your personal information. Do you think you will be trustworthy for our company? I don't think we will take you. So this person said, I am Indian. I will not join your company even if you give me. Because you are dumb people. How do you know my password? 1, 2. So I write 1, 1, 3, 4. I write 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. How do you know? Oh God, you are a genius. He says, yes, but I don't work with the dumb people. Be attentive. When he has given up on his own choice, he is happy. But when he was rejected, he is miserable. Don't get rejected in this world. Kick the world away. See, friends, these are the basics of life, spiritual life. All those people who become miserable, depressed, rejected, they are rejected by the world. We have no business to get rejected. Discard. Now the same example again. I am a girl married to a boy. So, I am a wife. Now, two examples. My husband dies or I divorce my husband. When my husband dies, I become depressed. But when I divorce my husband, I am happy. In both the cases, the husband is rejected, is it not? In one case, it was without choice. Other case, you are chosen. Choose to be happy. That's all. See, friends. So, the student is given this vision. Tade jati tanne jati tad dure tadvadantike tadantarasya sarvasya tadu sarvasyasya mayata. In this manner, when you become more and more contemplative, subjective, then his experience is yastu sarvani bhutani atmanneva anupashyati sarva bhutastamatmanam natacho vijugupsate. This experience of oneness with the totality removes all the misgivings, wrong understanding about the world. Therefore, we do not hate anybody. At the same time, we do not love anybody. When you love somebody, it is an action. When you have love for everybody, it is not an action. See, friends. In this manner, the wise man's experience in this very world now undergoes a complete change. See? Yasmin sarvani bhutani atma eva abhut vijanataha. He who has thus come to discover that the whole world is nothing but my own expanse, how can he have any delusion and doubt about something or somebody? In this manner, in the 8th mantra, the teacher tells, such a great master who has transcended the three bodies or the panchakoshas. He is a saint or a sage or a rishi, kavihi, manishi, paribhu, swayambhu. And such great masters, they give us the wisdom how to live in this world. See, friends, up to here, the complete understanding for the two types of people is given. Now, what is our life? Our life has got basically two aspects. One is karma, action, and second is upasana. Karma is done when we want achievement in this world. Upasana is done when we want achievement in the other world. Once I was going by a scooter, maybe about 5,000 kilometers I drove for some work, I was told. So not knowing anybody anywhere, and I was going through UP, not UP, Bihar, Rajasthan. I went to Jaipur and like that going. So, in one place I reached and asked somebody, I said, hey, who is in this city or town? Who is satsangi and all that? So they told me, I went there. And I said, hey, I come for this purpose. Will you be able to help me? They saw me with this dress and a helmet and a Babaji. So he asked me something. Then I spoke in English. So immediately he agreed. That day onwards, I started worshipping English. Angreji Maya ki jai. When you talk in Hindi, you are Gauka. These are professional secrets. So he said, okay, I understand your work. So first, this is lunch time, we'll take lunch. I said, okay. We went to his house. And he told me, be ready for getting bangings from my wife and my son. I said, as long as I get food, I'm okay. Moment we entered his house, we had to climb a few stairs, first floor. Wife said, aaj kis bhikari ko pakad ke laaye? So he looked at me. And I pretended I had not heard anything. No reaction. See, pretension is a great spiritual practice. See, like we pretend I am listening. See, if we listen, we will change. See, friends. And then we are taking food. So that time the sun came. And he said, you have got money to spend all these people, but you don't have money to give me one Maruti car. That time, that Maruti 800 has recently been introduced in India. There was a big hot cake that time. So he was very cool. He said, look here, let us finish our lunch and talk to you. So he was waiting for us to finish the lunch. And thereafter he said, look here, I'm a businessman. You are my son, therefore you will get this house after I die. And you will get the factory that we are running. But all the earnings that I have in my bank balance, I will not leave one rupee for you. All this money I am spending on this kind of activities because that gives me merit, and with the investment of this merit, when I die, I go to heaven. He was very clear. Now see, what a change it makes. Therefore, our scriptures are telling we are working on two planes, this world and life hereafter. So when we are working in this for this world, for them, karma is indicated. Karmande vadhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana ma karma phalahetubhuhu ma te sanghastu akarmani. And those who are concerned about their life after death, where they will go, hell or heaven, for them, upasana is told. See, when you do the upasana, you will go to Golok, you will go to Saket Lok, you will go to Kailash. And nobody knows who has gone to Golok and come low. Go and come. But then we trust that and we continue. And you will see those who are engaged in Upasana, they are having too many desires in their mind. And they have failed to fulfill their desires through their karma in this world. And therefore, they take their first startup is new gods, new Upasana. There's a startup. And so that they will get some kind of fulfillment of their desires. See, friends. But those who have nothing to gain in this world, and those who have no acceptance that we die and we go to hell and heaven, they don't accept it. Because neither we have died nor we are born. See, friends. Moral of the story, or the Tatparya Nirane, if it is not understood, we cannot enter Vedanta inquiry. Such people are good, but they are weaklings. They are very good, but they are all the time wanting some kind of babying support. And they become obsessed with that. They can't get out of it. Like, we study in our childhood something, because we are small, we are given some supports. Suppose the child has to be taught sums, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. Now these are concepts. Now how the child will understand? So we know the child's interest is in chocolates. So we tell, see, this is one chocolate, this two. But there are two chocolates. Now our attention is on 1 plus 1, 2. Child's attention is on chocolates. See? So in a school, the teacher asks, hey, you tell, you are not attentive. Yes, I am attentive, tell. I give you two chocolates, then your friend gives you two chocolates. How many chocolates you have? He said, five. The teacher gets angry. I gave you two, your friend gives you two. How many? He said, five. How come? I got one already in my pocket. The teacher was thinking, I am teaching mathematics, but the student's attention is only on the chocolate. Exactly the same way the scriptures are telling, you are a continuous unbroken existence. Before this body was born, you were in some other body. So you were there. In this body you are. When this body is destroyed, you continue and suffer or enjoy. So where did you die? See, my friends, the moral of the story is not understood. Because we are like the child, chocolates. We are not understanding the basics. And then for such a person, they are Bakri Eid, Mil Gaya Bakra. And then they will start, you do this thing, you do this thing, you go here, you go there, and then your desire will be fulfilled. If you have a problem will be solved. But we don't understand that all that is happening is for the Prakriti. Prakriti is that where Vikriti is natural. You cannot stop. Now what can be done that our body doesn't die? It will. Whether we want or we don't want. But the whole life is go to geriatrics department. And they will be putting so many tubes here and there and make you live long and make your people pay heavy bills. See, friends. Therefore, these two types of people, either they want success, fulfillment in this world, they do work hard, nothing wrong in that. But then that becomes only thing. But there are some wise people. They start learning from their experiences. Now what is the learning? Learning is, right from childhood what I have done? Nothing except trying to fulfill our desires. Now till date, have we come to a point, there are no more desires now? Then we learn, desires can never be fulfilled. Then, we analyze our desires. When we were children, we wanted those toys and things, so mad after that. But when we are grown up, now those things are there or not, it makes no difference. We don't hate those things, but we are not mad after them. Because we have grown out of those desires. And when we thus grow out of the desires, then only we become contemplative in life. And then the process of learning is initiated. So, these are the two areas, karma and upasana. Some people are busy only in karma. Some people are busy only in upasana. Both of them are extremist. Life is a balance between the two. Both are required. When we are living in this world, yes, do your karma, karmanyam adhikara. But when we are living in this world, keep attention on the quality of your mind after the job is done. If the mind is disturbed again and again, then for quietening the mind, upasana is indicated. See, friends. So, we have to have a perfect balance between karma and upasana. This is what is called technically as karma upasana samuchay. Both are to be conducted together, not only one way. And thereafter, the teacher says, what happens to this karma and upasana if it is done independently and if it is done together? So, two aspects of our life. One is our expression of life, and second is our field of expression. Two things. Like experience world, experience of the world, and experiencer of the world. So, this experiencer, what is he doing? Is he busy only in the karma, or only upasana, or together? Now, where is he living? Is he living in this world or in other world? These are the two areas which are now analyzed and explained for us to practice this knowledge. And these six mantras, they are so beautiful contradictions. Many people get lost in these contradictions. Andham tamaha pravishanti ye avidyam upasate tato bhuja ivate tamaha yaut vidyayagam rataha. First mantra, then second mantra. Anya devahur vidyaya anya dahura vidyaya iti shishrumadhiranam yenas tadvichachakshire. The third mantra, vidyam cha avidyam cha yastad vedo bhayagam sa avidyayam rutyum tirtva vidyayam rutamashnute. Now first of all, I'll translate simple straight way so that you misunderstand. And then we'll clear the misunderstanding. Andham tamaha pravishanti ye avidyam upasate. Those who are practicing avidya, ignorance, they end up in total darkness. Understood. What is difficult there? Andham tamaha pravishanti. Okay. Tato bhuja ivate tamaha ye vidya yagam rataha. But those who are practicing knowledge, vidya, they enter more darkness. Those who are practicing ignorance, avidya, they enter darkness. Those who practice knowledge, they enter more darkness. I don't know, it's good I have not studied. Now, the second mantra. Anya deva hur vidyaya, anya dahura vidyaya. the result, the karma, the fall of those who are following Vidya, they go to different place. Those who follow Avidya, they go to different place. Iti Shushruma Dhiranam. This is what we have heard from our teachers and the saints and the scriptures. Dhinastad Vijay Chakshire, those who instructed us about the total management of life according to scriptures. Then, third, Vidyamcha Avidyamcha Yastad Vedo Bhayagam Saha. He who is practicing both Vidya Avidya, knowledge and ignorance, practicing together. How can these two things can be practiced together? Either you practice knowledge or you practice ignorance. No. He said, Vidyam cha avidyam cha yastad vedo bhagyam saha ubhayam, together. So, what happens? Avidyaya mrityum tirtva. By the ignorance, you transcend the death. And vidyaya amrutam ashnute. And by the vidya, the knowledge, you attain immortality. Now see how many contradictions are there. And this comes because we are not taking the technical meanings of these words. See, words remain the same, but their meanings change according to the subject where that word is used. Like common example, in computer science and in English, there are many common words. Mouse. Spelling is also same. Where is my mouse? Get my mouse. So the servant goes, catches a mouse. Hello, Baba. See? So the words are same, but meanings are different. In Sanskrit, idam means this. And in Vedanta, idam means that which is recognized as other than the self. See the difference? In the same manner, here also, Vidya and Avidya, they are to be understood. So, Andham Tamaha Pravishanti ye Avidya Mupasate. Avidya is what? Avidya Kama Karma. Whenever there is incompleteness, then there is a sense of desire to attain completeness, and the desire prompts us into activity. Therefore, karma is the grandchild of ignorance. And when you do karma, how long will you do? Andham tamaha pravishanti. Now I am tired, I want to sleep. Even in the lecture, why? Andham tamaha pravishanti. See? You know, the science of a healthy spiritual life is when your sleep is good and your digestion is good. Oh, that means I am highly spiritual. Why? I can sleep anytime, anywhere. And I can eat the whole world all the time. See? Therefore, avidya is the field of karma. Now, you may do any karma. It has no end. And ultimately, we get tired. Therefore, those who are workaholics, they cannot sit quiet and be at peace. And then they get tired. And they get frustrated. I have done so much for the people, but they don't listen to me. Who asked you? See, this experience of mine many years before, I was new that time in my profession. That was the startup time. It was in Calcutta with my friend, elderly man. He invited me for Bhagavad Gita lectures. And there was another elderly man there also. So for breakfast, when we were sitting together, he asked me, now what do you do? I said, I do nothing. They said, I am Babaji. But here you have come for what? I said, for giving lectures on Gita. Do you think your lectures will change the people? I said, no, I don't think that way. Then why do you give? I said, papi pet ke liye. I don't want anybody to change. If you all will change, where will I go? Continue to be miserable. See, like the doctors have the prayer, sarve bhavantu na sukhinaha. If they become healthy, doctors become unhealthy. In the same manner, we survive on your miseries. Be miserable, we survive. He said, you are very peculiar. I said, the manufacturer's defect. I can't do it. Then second thing he said, how long are you going to teach Bhagavad Gita? I said, till I am alive. Now out of courtesy, I had to also ask, Babaji, I am sorry, I don't know you. You must be a great person. But I don't know who you are, what you are. If you want to make any old man happy, ask about him and don't listen. So he started. I was inspired by Mahatma Gandhi and Vinoba Bhave when I was in the first year of the college, and I left everything. And as per their instruction, I came to Northeast India in Nagaland. And I started this. I started school, college. I had done so much. Last 50, 60 years, I spent my whole life for them. Now, they are coming to kill me. They are destroying that institution which I built by the blood and sweat of my life. And then the real thing came out of him. The world is like a kutte ki dum, like a dog's tail. When he became bitter, I don't like bitter things. So I said, Babaji, the beauty of the dog is because of the crookedness of the tail. Imagine a dog having a tail like a dish antenna. Will it look good? See, friends, if you have served, be very attentive. If you have served, why should you become bitter? We serve our parents. Now, if we have served our parents, we will never become bitter. Because who is a servant? May sevaka sacharachara rupa swami bhagavanta. A servant never gets insulted. A boss gets insulted. See, friends, and this is what is the problem with the karma. Therefore, the teacher says that those who are engaged only in karma, they enter in the darkness, they expect too many things which will never happen, and they suffer. And tato bhuya yavate tamaha yav vidyaya gamrata. And much more darkness they enter who are practicing vidya. Here vidya means upasana. So life is two, karma and upasana. Karma is for this world, upasana is for the other world. Now those people who are excessively engaged in upasana, they are all the time only in this way, thinking, I have to go here, I have to go there. And as a result, they remain totally irresponsible for their responsibilities in this world. See, about this, I'll tell you one experience. One house I went in Thane for taking food, evening time. When I was coming out, the boy said, Swamiji, I'll drop you to the taxi stand. I said, okay, come. On the way, he says, Swamiji, you are a spiritual man. I said, yes, that's what people say. Then he said, my mother is also spiritual, but I had decided I will never be spiritual in my life. I said, okay, whatever you like. He said, do you know why? I said, I don't know. Your choice, your life. He said, I am fed up of spirituality. So what happened? I am the only son of my mother. I am not allowed to ride a motorcycle. Something will happen. If I had to reach 7 o'clock at home, it becomes 8 o'clock. All the gods are punished. And she herself doesn't take them. I will not take salt for 1 month. I will not take sugar for 1 month. And therefore, our house is all the time tensions. Gods will do something if you do this wrong. And therefore, I am fed up. Friends, if you have devotion for the Lord, you will not have fear in your heart. But where we go wrong, you know, we mistake upasana for devotion. Upasana is a means that you do, but devotion happens. Upasana is outside. devotion is inside. Upasana can be changed, devotion doesn't change. But when this is not understood, we get so obsessed with today Somwar, Shivaji, Mangala, Devi, and whole day, this upas, that upas, not eating this, not eating that. Ultimately, they become cranky. See, and then their understanding is impose their views on others. See, and such obsessed people, they end up in total solitude. Nobody wants them because they are, people are fed up. Tato bhujayivate tamaha yo vidyaya agamrataha. So upasana is done for what? I'll tell you in short before we go to the next. In upasana, the most important part is chanting the Lord's name. And Lord's name is chanted for what purpose? Be attentive. We are not troubled by the thoughts. We are troubled by the flow and the momentum of thoughts that is gathered in our mind. We are not troubled by the water. Water helps us to live. We are not troubled by the river. But when the flow of the waters is tremendous, then we are carried away by that. Exactly the same way. We only talk about disturbed mind, but recognize this. Disturbed mind is, we gather a momentum of thoughts in such a way that we are carried away by that thought. So we have to arrest. See, like today when we are coming, our Partha Sarathi was in a hyper mode. Boom, 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 coming. So, when you go in a speed, there is always a possibility of committing an accident. Then what the government has to do? Because where there are no cultured people, they are to be imposed on. You go to the Europe and other countries, when there is a yellow solid line, nobody crosses them. In our country, democracy. Therefore, they have to put the speed breakers. When you, in the same manner, thoughts are carrying away. Then speed breakers are given. Now, do chant Lord's name. Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. As a result, the momentum of the thought is arrested. But there we are still genius. There also we gather a momentum. Our Maya is superior than Bhagwan's Maya. We may transcend Bhagwan's Maya. He cannot transcend our Maya. See, friends. Upasana is done for aikagrartha. Aikagrartham upasanam. The mind should be made available whenever we want, for whatever purpose we want, for whatever period of time we want, for whatever way we want. If that mind is fully available, that is the result of upasana. But instead of that, when I do this thing, I will go to heaven and all fear. I think I told you this example. One person asked me in somewhere in another country, do you believe in God? I said, no. Then you will go to hell. I said, okay, what about you? I'll go to heaven. And neither he has seen the heaven nor I have seen the hell. But he is enchanted by the heaven and I am frightened by the hell. I said, if you are going to heaven, I'll go to hell. I'll prefer that. Whom are you frightening? But he will see all the upasakas, they are not living a cheerful, happy life all the time. Fearful. We go to the temple for joy. No, we go for fulfilling the desires. And therefore, Sashtanga Dandavan. according to the length of the namaskar and the time required is the list of the demands. And when all the demands are over, you get a thank. Again you start second one. Therefore, they do once, twice, thrice. These are the questions which we get. Therefore, I am telling you. So many people in South India, they do this Sashtang Nandra three times. I tell a very long list. It is carried over to the next page. First namaskar. Second. Go to the temple only for the sake of the Lord. You will be happy. See, friends. And therefore, Tato Bhuya Ivate Tamaha Yav Vidyayagam Rataha. They get lost only in this world because they are fulfilling their desires. Anya Deva Ahur Vidyaya, Anya Dahura Vidyaya. So when they are practiced separately, they end up separately. Yatha Karma Yatha Shrutam. Karma leads us to Pitrulok. And Upasana leads us to Devalok. These are the statements in the Upanishad. See, Karmana Pitrulokaha. Vidya Devaloka. Their Vidya means Upasana. And therefore you will see the Karma Kandis. They will be doing so much of Karma, Karma. This Shraddha, that Shraddha, this thing, that thing. A whole life goes only in that. Karma Kanda. And then when you do the Tarpadam, etc. Then your Pitrus are propitiated. Then whatever your desires you cannot fulfill, those Pitrus will be helping you to fulfill your desires. And thus you remain in this world only. There was one for a house somewhere in Madhya Pradesh. A child was born and the child was so attached to his grandmother. He is Dadi, father's mother, very attached. When he was small, yes, she was enjoying. Taking bath only with her, taking milk only with her hand. Then slowly started growing, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, 6 years. Not leaving that Dadi. And she was fed up. What to do with this thing? So, and his behavior became very peculiar, unexpected of a child. He will dictate her everything. Then they went to some pujari, puja poti, and they did some kind of horror, whatever it is. And they told, this is your husband from the last life. And then she started analyzing, oh God, yes, he decides what sari I should put on. He decides to whom I should talk or not. He decides where I should go or not. Exactly what my husband was doing. Because he has accepted that I am a soul, I am her husband, I don't want to give her a. So, again, I will be born as the grandchild of the same family and hold on to my wife. Andam tamaha pravishanti. How long you want to be in this world? World doesn't mean only this world. World means bhurva swaha maha jana tapa satyam atala vitala sutala tala tala visatala patala mahatala. These 14 worlds together constitute world. And we keep on going again and again. And how long? Get out of this rubbish. See, friends. Therefore, we have to practice both together. So, Anyadahura Vidyaya, Anyadahu Avidyaya, Iti Shushruma Dhiranam, Yenastad Vichichakshare. So, if we practice this together, what happens? Vidyaya, vidyamcha, avidyamcha, yastat vedo bhayagamsa, avidyaya mrityum tirtva, vidyaya amrtamashnute. Now when vidya, avidya, karma and upasana is practiced together as complement to each other, then what will happen? Avidyaya mrityum tirtva, When you are actively busy in your life, you transcend death. What is death? Three things. Alasya, Nidra, Pramad. Laziness, excessive sleep, and ability to repeat the same mistake more efficiently again and again is Pramad. This is death. But an active person can never be lazy, can never be oversleeping, and will never do the mistake again and again. That is death. Life has to be full of cheer, inspiration, dedication. Then it is lived. Otherwise, abaji ke kya karenge? Maro na fir. Therefore, never retire in your life. Never retire. Many people tell us, Swamiji, you keep on running, why you do like this? In Mumbai, my host, he was actually tired, therefore he told me. I came from Australia, midnight, it was raining also. And you know the airports, they don't have any place for the people to stand and wait. Now the new airports are better. So he received me at 1 o'clock at night. Next day, by evening flight, I was going to London. He says, Swamiji, why are you running? Come here, go there. Hardly you are here. Why don't you stay in one place? You have nothing agapiche, nothing ahead of you, behind you. Why you run? I said, okay, agree. Thank you for concern. Now, from now onwards, I'll stay in your house, not go anywhere. No, I don't mean that. See, Swamiji, what is the secret? Why people love you and receive you with such great honor? I said, only because before my arrival, they know my day of departure. I jaane ka kitna lenge? How much I have to pay for you to go from this house? Keep yourself busy, occupied. Never retire in life. So, avidya mrityum tirtva, we transcend these three enemies of life. Alasya, Nidra and Pramada. And you will see, a busy person alone is creative. It is said, if you go to a new place and you want to get some work done, don't search for a person who is free. Search for a person who is very busy. He is very busy because he is capable. A person who is all the time free because he is good for nothing. See friends, work also goes to those who are capable. Like if I had to eat food, so I won't go to him, I will go to his wife. Because she will give me food. See friends, so if we are seeking a right person for a right job in the same manner, the Lord is also searching a right person for a right job. So what should be the rightness in us? No laziness. Alasya. Second, Nidra. Oversleeping. And the third thing is Pramad. So avidya mrityum tirtva. When you are actively busy, you will transcend this death. And Tirtva Vidya Amrutam Ashnute. And by Vidya, by Upasana. What happens by Upasana? Be attentive. The positive side of Upasana. The positive side of Upasana is we are no more having the strong feeling, I have done this. So be very attentive. When we do karma, I is involved. Now we have to delete this I. So this I is deleted by Upasana. Yad yad karma karomi tat tad akhilam shambho tava aradhana. Now see these two things together. When you are dynamically busy, you have to be assertive. Then you can do the things. So their I is born. But this I also to be deleted. Then bring Upasana. And these two things together, when they are practiced, you are dynamically busy in this world, yet you won't have the arrogance of success or a guilt of failure in life. this perfect balance of life is called as spiritual practice. See, friends. And nobody can help us in this. So, vidyamcha, avidyamcha, yastad vedo bhayagamsa, avidyaya mrityum tirtva, vidyaya amrutam ashnute. Vidyaya, by this upasana, by devotion, dedication, surrender to the Lord, amrutam ashnute. What is immortality? Be attentive. It's a very subtle topic. If somebody is not sleeping, you cannot wake him up. Like for example, this is just an example. Now you are not sleeping. So I don't have to wake you up. So you are not sleeping. Similarly, if we take ourselves to be the absolute divine reality, no problem. But if we understand I as a mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, these are not real. Then I don't have to do anything. Thus, we gain total freedom. As absolute reality, we are immortal. And as a body, we are immortal. As a jiva, we are immortal. When the body dies, what happens? What is body? It is an assembly of these five great elements. When the body dies, first of all, the individual air merges with the total air. Individual heat merges with the total heat. Individual water merges with the total water. Individual earth goes back to earth. And the space which was occupied by this body is released. Who died? When we take, this is a beautiful mala. Oh, very nice. But is mala something real? It is assembly of flowers going through this thread. Suppose I break this, I won't break, I like it. Suppose I break it and separate them out. What is lost? Nothing is lost. When my childhood has gone, what did I lose? I am the same. Then teenage gone, middle age gone, nothing is lost. So when attention is on this absolute, no question of death, immortality is attained. When attention is on this world, which is an appearance, appearance never dies. When we stand in front of the mirror, there is an appearance reflection in the mirror. So when the mirror is removed, oh poor, the reflection must have died. No. Neither it goes with the mirror, nor it goes anywhere. Why? Because it never existed. When it is not existing, how can it die? Exactly the same way. The jiva, 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 he will die only if he is real. Husband can never die because he is not real, he is illusion. See, once we understand this principle, then you will see the total life changes, friends. Therefore, avidyaya mrityum tirtva, vidyaya amrutam ashnute. In this manner, we attain fulfillment in life. This is the purpose of studying the Upanishad. And beyond that, there is nothing. And when there is a fulfillment in life, there are no loose ends left to be tied. Like the bankers. These days, we have to even talk very careful about bankers. Earlier, they used to say KYC. Now, we have to say KYE. You know KYE? What is KYC? Know your customer. KYE, know your employee. You don't know what kind of people are there. So, when we go to the bank, we have to put the things in a proper way and then we are relaxed. in the same manner. By this type of perfect balance in life, we are at peace. So a bank person, when he leaves the bank, before that, all things must be complete. Nothing is pending for tomorrow. Same way, let our life be lived today completely. Nothing is left. The net result will be, we will be living day to day without any hang-ups of the past or worries of the future. Avidyaya mrityum tirtva vidyaya amrutam ashnute. Now, this is how we have to work. Now the second question comes. Where should we work? What should be the field? Now, like these three mantras contradictory, here also we will take this, the field where we are supposed to live in this world. Andham tamaha pravishanti ye asambhuti mupasate tato bhuya ivate tamaha yo vidya sambhutyagamrataha. Anya devahur sambhavan, anyada ahura asambhavan, iti shushrumad hiranam, yenastad vijachakshire, sambhutim cha vinasham cha, yastad vedo bhayagam saha, vinashena mrityum tirtvam, sambhutyamrtam ashnute. Now these are the two areas, sambhuti and asambhuti. And where we are functioning and how we are functioning, these are the two things which tells the quality of a life of a person. How we are functioning and where we are functioning. In Ramayana, one story comes. When Hanumanji was going in Sri Lanka, that this Lankini, who was a watch person, watch woman there, she caught hold of him and said, "The thieves are my food. So you are entering the Lanka, therefore you are a thief, I want to eat you." Now if she was little wise, who was the thief? Real thief was Ravana, who has stolen Sita. She should eat Ravana first, then her. In the same manner, we are doing this karma and upasana, but which field? We must know where to operate. And also we must know how to operate. These two things makes our life perfectly balanced. This and the remaining prayer mantras we'll try to finish tomorrow. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnahat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om, Sri Gurubhyo Namaha, Harihi Om.